Right, I always get asked about plate combinations. So let me walk you through every different combination that you would need for all of the different die cutting and embossing functions that you're going to do. Now let's start by just looking at what the plates are, okay? Now with your new Gemini 2, you've got your two outer cutting plates, which we've made white. And the reason they're white is because you've got an optical sensor in your Gemini 2, as opposed to the mechanical sensors we had in the original Geminis. So you need to make sure you break that beam of light. That's the only reason they are different. So we've got two outer cutting plates. Then you've got a plastic shim. Your plastic shim you're going to use every time you use a regular cutting die. Whether it's a regular thin die or a multimedia die, any die cutting, you always need to use the plastic shim. Now the magnetic shim is an optional one. This one you do use for a thin metal die, but you don't use for a thicker multimedia die. And you can either use it as a magnetised base to hold your dies in place, or you can use it as a shim just to make the sandwich up. You've then got a metal plate. Now your metal plate you're going to use if you've got a really intricate die and you need more pressure, or if you're cutting into material and you need a nice crisp clean cut like fabric or leather or denim. And finally we have an embossing plate, and that is when we're going to emboss our dies with this. So it's not for use with embossing folders, it's when we're embossing our dies. So a lot to take in, and I'm going to walk you through all the separate plate combinations. Now, for a thin metal die, and I'm going to take a really intricate detailed one, so it's one where we're asking it to cut a lot of times. What you're going to do is we're going to start with our base cutting plate. Always have the base cutting plate at the very bottom and the very top. Now, if we're making the sandwich up exactly as per the instructions, you're going to use the magnetic positioning plate to hold your die in place. So if you do that, we first of all remember we must add the shim in, so you're going to add your shim on the bottom. Then we're going to put our magnetic positioning plate, and we're going to use that as a positioning plate to position the die. So because it's magnetic, it's going to hold that die in place. You've got all of your measurements. Now the die is held on with the cutting face upwards. So we need to cut upwards into the card. So you take your piece of cardstock, and the cardstock must go face down over that die. Now people always ask why I don't do it this way when I demonstrate on TV, and that's because you can't see the die anymore. That's not a very good demonstration if you can't see the die. So that's why the instruction booklet looks different to what you'll see us doing quite often when we demonstrate live on TV. Because as I'm looking now, you've got no idea what it is that I'm die cutting, but it's going to die cut through the cardstock and into my top cutting plate. So the top cutting plate goes on the top. You've always got those white plates on the top and bottom. They are going to be what touches the rollers. And we're going to offer it into the mouth of the machine. Now, you saw that sensor engaged. That's because we've got the white cutting plate, so we've got the optical sensor. The glide feet allow me to move this round, easy be able to take this out of the back. And what you'll see is that should have cut an absolute dream. So now, yes, if we lift that up, now bear in mind I've stuck that down to the base, so I just need to be careful to lift that up. You can see that's cut beautifully well. Now, if you just want a die cut, that's all you need to do. But with most thin metal dies, you can emboss the dies. So let me show you the sandwich combination if we are embossing dies. We need to take the magnetic plate out. So that's the difference. You take the magnetic out, and we're adding in that embossing mat. And the only important thing to remember is the embossing mat must go as though you're cutting into it. So you can see the cutting bits face up. We're going to lie that embossing mat down. Now, don't worry that it's going to cut into it, because it won't, because we've taken the magnetic shim out, so you don't have enough pressure to actually be able to cut into that. So we're going to do it so it embosses into that. Pop that top plate back on there, always the top plate's touching the roller. And then through it goes. So that second pass through is the embossing. Remember, that's optional. You don't need to emboss your dies. It's just if you want the design exactly how the die's been put together, often they are cut and embossed dies. Now, if I lift this out, if you do like to tap your dies to take the edge pieces out, make sure you tap it so that it's the back of the metal, not the cutting edge you're tapping on there. I just lift this out, and you can see there, we don't need to poke any bits out. That is cut to absolute perfection, despite being a really intricate die. And you can see it's all of this embossed detail that we've got around the butterfly, for example. That is why we would send it through and do a second time through embossing. So that is how we do cutting and embossing dies. Next, I want to show you if we're going to cut thicker materials. Now, I've just taken some leather here, but anytime you are using a multimedia die, so that's one of our dies that's rose gold, you can see they're thicker than a regular thin metal die. And the difference in thickness between the two is why we don't need the magnetic mat. So what you're going to do is we're going to take that thicker metal die and we're going to die cut it. Now, when you're cutting any material like fabric, denim, leather, you want to get a nice crisp cut. So what we're going to do is we're going to add the magnetic shim. So very important that you understand we always have the base plate at the bottom, then our magnetic shim. And then what we're going to do is pop your leather down and I'm going to put the die on top of it so that you can see what I'm die cutting. So this time, the cutting piece goes through the material and into the metal. That's the key thing. We're going through the material into the metal, okay? You need the plastic shim, but you don't want your magnetic. It's too thick if you add the magnetic shim as well. We're going to go with that top cutting plate and we're going to offer that through the mouth of the machine. So it goes into the machine, and because we're only cutting on the top part of the machine, if you want to pause it and reverse it, you can use that reverse function to save waiting for the plates to pass all of the way through the machine. And then when we take this out now, you'll see, there we go, that that has cut absolutely no problem. Now, the next thing I want to do is I want to emboss that leather. Now I'm going to emboss it with a 3D embossing folder. Now, when we're doing a 3D embossing folder, whether we're putting card, leather, tissue paper or anything else in, have a little feel inside. There's the element that's debossed, so I want it that way up showing on the leather. With a 3D embossing folder, let me get the small size plates out because I want you to see how we do the half size. It's exactly the same set of plates, the same thickness, everything, they're just half the size, which means they pass through in half the time. Now, with a 3D embossing folder, you only need one of the base plates, you need your shim, and you need your magnetic. So, you never want your magnetic touching the rollers. So make sure your magnetic goes inside the sandwich. You can have your plastic shim or the outer cutting plate, but never the metal shim, the magnetic shim or the metal shim touching the rollers. So, that goes inside. We're going to put the magnetic and the top shim, and we're going to send this. And because we're using the Gemini 2, the optical sensors run the full length of the machine, which makes it really easy to be able to pass that through. And you can see that is embossed perfectly. And it's the same whether you're using paper, fabric, tissue paper. In fact, let's do some tissue paper. Exactly the same sandwich. Even though the tissue paper is much, much thicker, it still goes in between the base cutting plate, your magnetic, and your clear plate. And I'm just going to offer them into the mouth of the machine. If it's ever too thick, remember it's going to pause it and it'll just return that out to you. But as that comes out there now, I mean, that's about 50 layers of tissue paper there that I've embossed. And it's embossed even, let's go right to the middle, even emboss those middle pieces absolutely perfectly. Okay? So that's embossing with a 3D embossing folder. Now, if you've got a regular embossing folder, so not a 3D folder, I've got one here that is an embossing folder. Now, it's got dies built into it. It's still just a regular embossing folder. It's still the same thickness as a regular embossing folder. So we're going to use the regular embossing folder sandwich. Now, your regular embossing folder sandwich, if I just take this card and I'm going to wrap this around the front of the card so we can just die cut and emboss into the front of the card. I'll use the small plates again. For a regular embossing folder, you just need the two outside cutting plates, okay? So you're going to take those two outside cutting plates, sandwich that in between the two plates. You don't need any additional shims. That goes straight in there, and you can see one pass through the machine, and in the same pass, it will do all of the die cutting and the embossing at the same time. So you see there, when I lift this out, all of those die cut pieces will just pop out straight in front of you there. And that is exactly the same for any regular embossing folder.